Well, today I'm going to talk about a topic which probably I think it's most of us face issues with, like, dealing with, right? So we are going to discuss on the topic which is on, like, how to be a very top on our to-do list. Okay, now simple. Let's take. I would love to become, like, very. Let's have a very practical approach. Many of us, we feel at the work, or even in fact, in today's lockdown period, that I'm always on my work, or I'm continuously working, but I'm not effective, right? Where you have to manage, I'm managing my household, I am trying to manage my work from home. So, but I'm not satisfied with what I'm doing it. Be it even at the workplace, we feel that we are doing a lot of things, but we are not recognized. We are still at the same stage. Why I'm not moving to the next level, though I'm putting a lot of efforts of mine. Okay. Let me to be very honest with you. Why this happens? Okay, that's the first questions. Why such kind? Why it is with me, or it is with you, or if it is any of the one, or why the others can be a very successful, or they are very effective when it comes to the to-do list. The reason is, of course, many a times we are not very focused in terms of what we are looking forward to achieve. So very important thing is, I think it is very, very important to have a very clear mindset and very focused approach on doing anything what you are doing at the workplace. Let it be it your to-do list, or be it your work objective. But yeah, everything start with, like, if you have a very clear objective, your work, your to-do list will be equally effective, or it will be equally focused and achievable goals. Okay, so important is, like, we many a times we are not very clear what I am looking to do it, or what how to start my day. Another things what happens is, which I probably I understand or I see is, we all feel that when we start sitting creating a list of the to-do, we will write down, like, 100 things. And the best part or important is, like, I think we'll miss out on, which is a very, very critical task which we're supposed to complete it, which we really later in the day we realize, okay, I should have done that, or why I did not include it in my list. Okay, so we will purely talk about a subject today on how we can effectively create our to-do list. Okay, so I wanted to share a very short stories of my practical way, or probably my approach toward creating a to-do list very effectively. So I had a friend, who's a very senior, in fact, in one of the organizations, and he's at the head levels, and many people are reporting to him. So his profile is a very, very large in terms of he has to be a multitasker and managing a lot of branch and so on types. So we were having a very casual discussion in terms of, okay, fine, what's happening, and how do you manage your work, and how effectively you are able to drive such a large team. So I asked him, very casually, that how do you plan your day? In fact, how you are so effective in terms of, like, achieving your objectives at the work. So he told me a very simple thing that, Bhakti, look, on my desktop or on a laptop, I have my, like, list of the things. I keep writing on my task. That's the habit I have developed. So he will write, like, as and when he'll remember, he'll start writing the task which he wants to complete it. And then further he will break it down. Okay, fine, what is it? Then he will plan your next day in terms of, from this task or what he's supposed to do it, what is important things to do it in the next day. Okay, so this is how it gives him a clear objective in terms of, okay, fine, and during the day, course of the day, like, there were, like, 15, 20 things came across in my work related areas, and what I have to carry on next day. Okay, Second thing, what you know, is an important is like, you know, to stick to what you are expected to do or what you are supposed to have the to-do list. Now, you know, I feel it is very important that, you know, when you sit and define your to-do list, don't do it as a, like, you know, just one of the activity. I think, you know, many of us, what we feel is, okay, let me just get into a force of doing, create my to-do list. I will sit and, like, you know, mess of a lot of things happening around. And then I will start writing, okay, fine, this I have to do, and X, Y, Z, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 things I'm supposed to do. But that is something like, you know, you are writing it enormously, or you are just, it's a very vague full list, I would put it in this way, like, you know, which is you have created, but there is no back of the mind in terms of why you are creating it or why it is important to be a part of your list. So I think first and foremost, what I suggest to everyone is that start having a day prior, you know, creating your to-do list. Okay. Now, I'm again repeating, a day prior of your to create a to-do list. Don't do your to-do list like, you know, once you reach to office or when are you about to start your day. Because already you have a lot of things which is going around in your mind. So it will be, definitely it's going to be ineffective when you wanted to actually focus on things. When you are free from your daily chores, or when your mind is absolutely peaceful, your list will be equally effective and equally objective. And you know, I can bet on you on that, you know, that it is definitely going to be a very, very helpful to you. So that's a very important thing, that do not create your list like, you know, when you are in a chaos, when you are you know, in the jumbles, or when there is a lot of things which is going in the mind. Try and create a habit of creating your to-do list a day before, or before you start your day at least, you know. So that's a very, very important thing. So what happens now, the next question is, okay, fine, I am doing it, like, you know, I'm creating my to-do list a day before, I have started doing that. But first of all, I don't understand, like, you know, what I'm supposed to be, what should be a part of my to-do list, or what should not be a part of my to-do list, like important and less important, right? Okay, so how you will, like, you know, now the next question which most of us bother is, like, you know, how to differentiate between what is my important task and what is my not important task in my list. So let's go back, like, you know, I have created a list of 10, 15 things which has come up in my mind that I'm supposed to carry out in the next day. Now, how do I filter it so that I'm more focused on my to-do list, correct? Or my to-do list is a more effective and a top on, like, an achieving it. Okay, so next is, like, you know, okay, when we are saying that, okay, focusing on how you are differentiating it. Now, there are three ways or three simple questions you should ask yourself, right? Okay. Now, the very first is, like, you know, you ask a very three simple questions to yourself. What is, like, you know, if you have to, out of these task list, if you have to select only one task, okay, which is a very important for you, which one you select? I repeat again, if you have only one task to complete from the list of the tasks you have created, which will be that task to be which task you will select? I think that helps a lot, correct? You can also ask a question, like, to yourself, that if I'll complete any of the one task, I think that will be removed from my list, or it will be, like, you know, everything else will be easier. I repeat, which task you should take it up, or any task, any one task which you think if I'll complete that task will make my things easier or will not lead me out of the unnecessary chaos, right? Third thing which you can ask yourself, it's a very, very important question, and I'm sure I think all of you will relate to it, or probably each of us can relate to it, is which task, if I will not complete, will impact my work? Okay, I'm repeating it. So what will happen, or let me put me in this way, what will happen, the worst possible thing which will happen if I'll not complete any of the one task? Now what happens is, for an example, okay, if you are, if you in a work, if I want to be very specific, when we are working, you have to send the report, or you have to do the announcement, or you have to do a presentations, or you have to share some sales projection numbers. Okay, so if you will not do that particular task, or if you will not complete that, what the worst thing will happen? You will get a nasty comment, you will possibly get a nasty emails from your superior ones, or it will hamper your performance, or you have to listen to the nonsense at times, right? Or unwanted comments from the people. So this will help you to define, have a very clear thought on the objective list of the tasks which you have to complete, right? I think it's easy. So we are going back like a day prior. We are creating a list of 10, 15, 20 things, whichever comes in the mind. Then we rethink on the list. But okay, fine, what is important or what will help me if I have to select only one task, which is the one? If I have to one task to complete, which will move myself out of the unnecessary situations, or it will complete the task, or a worst thing happen if I'll not complete the particular task. So that will give you a clarity in terms of what is important. So you will start creating, you're filtering out the list of the important task for yourself, which you have to carry out on the next day. Right? Okay. So I think it gives you a very easy, it gives you a very, very subtle, very, very clear, your mind becomes absolutely clear that, okay, out of the 15, I think there are only five things which probably have to focus upon, right? Or you don't take many, many things in your list. Don't try to make your, task list as your book, or as a list of the everything possible you are, looking to do it. Because it is, let's be very practical, that you cannot do everything in one day. You cannot complete 15, 20, 100 things in a day. You possibly maybe, but probably it will be a more of unwanted things and more less focus on the wanted areas. So let's be very, very practical on that area. Okay. Now, once you have created that list, okay. Now the next thing comes is how I can be a very focused on even completing my objective list of the task. Okay, that's the one challenge. Now, many a times let me tell you what happens is we select the task which we like to do it, or we select the activity which we like to do it. Now, though my profile is, let me give you my own example to relate with you all, or possibly you can relate with your own profile. My profile talks about everything as a head HR, I'm supposed to do it. But I like certain areas to be focus upon, or I like to do certain work. And I at times, I unlike to handle certain areas. But end of the day, I think as a profile, we have to be a complete and we have to do it, right? So we cannot escape my, we cannot define our list based on the liking and not liking. Okay, I cannot be a choosy on that because end of the day, we have to be a very productive and end of the day, we are looking to be a very, very, have an objective of being a very productive for the organization or for ourselves also actually. So my what I'm giving is I think it not only affects your personal routine or probably it will help us to handle our household or personal task list or even it will help us to obviously in the professional life as well. Okay, so coming back to how we can be a very, very objective to achieve the task created by us. Okay, so here is now start writing. Now for an example, I'm supposed to share a certain important list or the data MISs or XYZ thing with the management. Or I'm supposed to create, to create the presentations on XYZ. To make it more interesting, okay, write down if you will achieve particular task, what will be, what you will achieve as a result of the task, what you will get. That will be absolutely or it is going to be completely on the good thing to look at it, right? Reward, it is kind of a reward, if you are doing X thing, how it is rewarding. So that reward will motivate you further to see, to ensure that you complete that task. I repeat, if you are aligning your task with the reward, I think it will make you more motivated to complete that task. So write down you have a five list of two things, okay, and in that you are even mentioning linking it to the rewards. So it gives you a very clear picture in terms of, okay, fine, I have to do it. Now the question is how to make it more interesting? Okay, what I do generally, I practice or we do at the work. Initial days or that becomes later the habit also. What happens is try to make your task list a very beautiful or very attractive. Okay, many people, what they do is, they will simply write on a piece of paper, whatever they get it here and there. And they will, I have made my task list. Put it on your office wall or a desk wall for you to remember it. Okay, I'm supposed to do it, right? You take it as a very, very casual, you mention it in a very casual way. Okay, I'm supposed to do it, so I've created the one. Try to make your task list very, very neat, very, very beautifully written or very, very clearly written. So possibly have a very, I'm not expecting someone or I think it is not important to have a beautiful diaries and all. You can possibly have your simple notebook, which will mention the date, list of the task and task, which is important. You are highlighting with the different colors. Use highlighters for making it to differentiate important or not important or on a priority and a less priority. Okay. So second is so once you do this kind of a thing, I think it will make you also look happy in terms of, I'm doing it, right? End of the day, you can always evaluate in terms of what you could complete and what you could not complete. So I'll tell you, it is a very beautiful exercise end of the day when you think, you have created a very focused list of around 5-6 things and you are able to do 4, which is not a bad thing. And then actually you have ticked those activities or a task which you have completed. So slowly, gradually, it gives you a very focused approach in a way to do your daily work. Okay. Now, so this is the way I think, you know, it makes you, it helps you to be very, very focused on, you know, your work areas. And I think it gives you a very clear objective that what you are expected to do, where you are supposed to focus upon, and where you are supposed to eliminate yourself from. Because many of, most of us juggles between what is important, what is not important. Okay, now, another, you know, things which generally, which we all feel or which happens, you know, in our work is that, okay, I have made my list. I am trying to make it very beautiful. I am tracking my, you know, the task list, and I'm trying to complete also in a very focused way. But then, like, you know, a lot of other works comes, and then I get into that and my focus is lost. This happens. It's a very, very, I think it's a, it happens with everyone, including me as well. So how to do handle that? So here is, I would tell you, so the that is the one reason I have mentioned very clearly, create your task a day before. Create so that it gives you a very clear objective, keeping a time frame of approximate, like, you know, how much each task will help you to complete a task, each task, the time it will take or to complete that particular task, how much time you will take. So, so you are starting your, one is like, you know, what happens is you are anyways, you are starting your days in a very focused way. So you are on the track and doing your task on a time. But for keeping yourself on a track and approach and having, like, you know, losing, not to lose your track in unnecessary or unwanted, like, you know, the work things which comes in between, that's something we have to manage by self. So for an example, like, you know, okay, I've started creating something and I am focused on that. In between, like, you know, my management calls me or my director calls me, okay, Bhakti, this is what something I'm supposed to do it. Okay, fine. But it is equally important that we come back on our focus. We repeat, we come back on focus. And in fact, in your daily list, you can also mention somewhere when you're evaluating it, what has happened which is good, or probably what the other things you have managed to do it along with your task. I repeat, okay, while you are creating a list, when we already have a list of a focus to do list, we can also, when you are reviewing your list, you can have, like, you know, okay, fine, what are the other things which has come in between to complete your task, and which is the unwanted things which has affected to complete your task, right? For an example, I get into a, like, an unnecessary flow. So slowly you are filtering your process of eliminating and focusing on your work. I repeat, while you are practicing these things, you will slowly eliminating your unwanted and unrequired distraction. And it will lead you to be a more focused and more productive, right? So you, while you are supposed to complete a 6 tasks, you have only done a 3 tasks, but there were other 2 tasks which were, like, you know, of high priority has come up in between, which you could also complete, will give you a satisfaction. While you are, another example, while you were supposed to complete a 6 task, you could do only 2 tasks, but you got into a list of the unwanted things will help you to decide on the next day that while, if such situation comes, how diplomatically you have to answer, you know, or you have to be out of that situation, or you have to skip yourself. See, remember one thing, you always ask yourself, whether I am required to be a part of this or whether I am not required to be part of this. Whether it is important, if it is not going to be an effective for myself or for my presence, I think you should be able to skip it. So this is what it is all about. I think if you want, we can go back and we can just summarize in terms of like, you know, I will just summarize in terms of what we have discussed. We all have the unbaked, we are all into a situations where we feel we are not important, or we are still in the same place, or we are not able to complete it. So to be very focused, have your list of the activities which you are supposed to do it. Eliminate the unimportant activities, asking self three questions, which is like, you know, which is the only one important task which you are supposed to do it. One important task which will eliminate yourself for doing the unnecessary things, and the worst thing which can happen if you will not complete that task. So that gives you a clear picture of important task which is to be performed the next day. So second is obviously like have your task prepared a day before, then doing it on the day in a very peaceful mind. Try to be creating your task a very, very neatly and effectively written, where you are further differentiating with the color code of like an important, not important. Review your task list for to prepare yourself for the next day, wherein you are also getting into the unwanted discussions, unwanted tasks, and which you could also complete the important task along with the top priorities which you already have in your plate. So probably I think this will really help you to make yourself very focused on your approach and things like that, right? I'm open to take the questions from anyone if you have it. Okay, now I have a question from Ananya. Hi, Ananya. Ananya has a question that thinking for one's self also means standing up for themselves. How do I work on taking a stand for myself and learning not to say no? So here what I say is, that is the reason I think Ananya mentioned, like, you know, while once you start practicing certain steps in terms of like, you know, differentiating important and not important, you will be, naturally you will be very, very, focused on the work. Then, then getting into the unwanted things. And you have to diplomatically and say no for the things which is not important. For an example, now in our work areas, it happens that, okay, fine. Please help me out to doing X things, and please, like, you know, why don't you attend X meeting or Y meeting, which probably you know somewhere you are not important to. So you can always say in a very diplomatically way to even a seniors or even your colleagues that I think I have some of the important tasks which I'm supposed to complete and present it to the management. So I would like to carry on with those tasks. I'm just excuse me if it is a possible for you and carry out and lead that particular meeting or agenda. So that I think it will put you in a good note, and it, you can simply, like, you know, you are out of the situation of not to be an odd kind of a saying no to it. Okay, so next question is from Tia Sam. How to manage my work and home without losing my sanity? So I think already I have mentioned, like, you know, that we all feel while we're working at home, we at times we feel we are out of focus or we are losing our focus. So your a day prior list will help you out with creating, list of, important tasks. So end of the day, I think probably it is very important that we plan our day. That's what I think I mean all about, that let's have a very planned day instead of like a vague day. If you all in the morning, if you will start thinking that, okay, I have to finish my cookings and I have to sit at my work and XYZ times, but like today I got up late and I'm not able to, like, you know, focus on my work and now everything is just stretched and all, it doesn't work. So somewhere you have to create a list of the things which you want to do it on the next day, and then, like, you know, plan your day accordingly, which is important, which is must require to do it. Okay, so I think not many of the questions probably I see here right now. What I can do for you all is you know, I will create a small presentation which I will share it with the jobs for her on this particular topic. A one pager for kind of a thing, which probably you can practice and you can always have it on your wall for you to practice and follow it. So that will, I think, certainly help you to be more focused and to be more productive, which I think will be shared soon with you, maybe in a day. Yeah. Okay. So thank you very much. Thanks everyone for listening to it, and looking forward to have many more such sessions with you all. Thank you very much. Stay safe, stay at home. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.